we're here at the video wall station, and I would like to introduce you to our product manager, Danielle. Danielle, what news are we showing here?
Good morning, Jörg. Yes, so we are showing our hybrid system-based video wall product family, and we have our Luma graphics card, Luma Pro, and we have a new addition this year that we're introducing. It's an 8-output graphics card that is in a single slot. So very convenient to create a very high density system in a smaller form factor. So you get 8 outputs driving 5K 60, or it can be configured in 8K with 4 outputs. So that's the first product. We also are showing our new, well, we have two flavors. So this is our C4K card. So this is a quad HDMI 2.0 capture card, so that you can use it. Now that the Luma series have IP decoding capabilities, we don't need to have IP decoding on the capture card. So this is a capture card, very high quality for inputs, 4K capable.
So what is the benefit of a system-based video wall controller if you have output cards and capture cards?
It's very flexibility. So you can do, you can drive a number of displays. You can put up to 4 cards in the system, giving you, with a frame lock cable, giving you a full frame locking capability across your surface. It gives you also the ability to scale, to bring, to be able to do IP video wall and HDMI, so with baseband signal. So you can configure, you can create a system, you can decide how many outputs and how many inputs, and you have all of this into a nice, powerful workstation, and you can run your control software on that workstation.
Perfect. So basically, any kind of content we can bring to the wall, SDI, HDMI, DisplayPort, and also IP streams.
Absolutely.
Wonderful solution. Correct. So, but we are talking more and more about AV over IP. So what kind of solution can we show here?
Yes, so we'll be in the showing for the first time in Europe at ISC the Mura DVW appliance. So this is a IP-based, high-performance IP-based distributed video wall appliance, which allows you to create fully synchronized video surface of any size and rectangular shape. So the unit here has 4 HDMI 2.0 output, able to do 4K 60 on one unit. And when you add more units to your wall, you see the output capability, so you can drive more screens. And we do that with full synchronization of the video and the video synchronization of the display. So everything is perfectly synchronized.
Perfect. So, and then you have the boxes here, the video wall controllers, all synchronized, but how do you get the content to be displayed?
So, well, it's IP-based. So it's H.264, it's HEVC, 420, and 444, so for pristine quality, content quality. In fact, we have here a little demo where we can see the different type of content that we can bring into our wall very easily. And we have some camera that are IP-based, and you can see them in this area there. This is a PTZ HEVC camera. You just create a source and display on your wall. Nothing is needed.
Very flexible. Perfect.
And if you have other type of contents that that is not H.264 HEVC, like NDI, for instance, you'll see that in a later video, but we have our Vion, and we're using the Vion gateway processor to allow us to bring other streams, capability, you know, NDI, JPEG XS, convert it into a format that is supported on our distributed video wall, and then we can display it.
Perfect, wonderful. We used to have a Windows-based application, Mura Control, for Windows to create layouts and position all the sources on the screen. What's coming here? It's still available, but there's something new, I heard.
Absolutely. So we're showing a premium feature, which is a new web-based control interface. So I didn't talk when you one of our key themes for the DVW is it's easy to deploy and it's easy to configure and it's easy to create layouts. I haven't shown earlier the configuration tool, but it's a web-based application that runs on your Chromium, any kind of it can be Mac OS and Windows, and you have your system to create to configure your video wall. And then to control that, we have the Mura control, and this is what we're showing as a technology preview at the show, where you can create layouts and very easily. So I can switch from different layouts using the new application web interface. And for instance, I could go with a layout that we've created for the show that shows the... So there you go. So basically, I've created a control room layout where you have like 71 IP traffic camera that we can display on our big video wall using this nice application, this nice web control interface.
And all these 72 streams are all decoded by the devices.
By the devices.
Very powerful.
It's distributed. So as you add more devices, you get more performance. So each device, for instance, is capable of doing 5 4K 60 decoding on each device, or 18 1080p 60. As you add more devices, you increase, it scales linearly in terms of performance capability.
Perfect.
However, the other thing that is very important is you don't have to precisely position. You can be overlay things. So I have another full screen demo here. So it's a single source that this is a clip that we made. It's 8K, almost 8K, 60. And I have to activate it to show it. It takes a few seconds. And right now I have a single clip that spans across the entire visual surface.
If I read that correctly, it's a 16K surface which we have here.
It's 19,000 pixels by 1150. That's a lot of pixels, yeah. But it's all managed by the DVW. And one of the things that's important is that with the synchronization, it's based on the IPMX PTP standard. We are able to synchronize everybody. And when you display a big screen, a big clip like that, every DVW is contributing to decoding and displaying their part of. And when you stitch it together, it's all synchronized. You don't see any tearing.
And there is this NMOS, which is always coming along with this IPMX standard. What about DVW?
Well, this is in the plan. So we don't have it right now, but yes, it's part of, like, PTP is IPMX, and we're going that route.
Perfect.